hearty welcome to all of you, dear students. So this is the lecture that we have of metallurgy. Right? I'll first give you a bird's eye view, a sneak peek into the entire lecture. We'll divide it in two parts, so this video would be part one of metallurgy. Yep. So, now I want you also to be very involved in this. It should be interactive. So, no matter wherever you're sitting, if you know the answer, you tell it to me. Right? So, metallurgy. First, I would like to know what is the difference between a mineral and an ore. What's the difference between the two? Come on. Mineral and an ore. A mineral can be any element or compound. It can be an element. It can even be a compound. Okay? So, any element or any compound which occurs naturally in the earth's crust is called a mineral. Naturally in the earth's crust is called a mineral. Any element or compound. So, what do you mean by element? Any element, it could be Fe, it could be Al, it could be Mg. It could be any element, means these were the metals. It could also be any non-metal, for example, phosphorus, for example, sulfur, element. So these are all your elements. And now if I ask you to tell me the compounds, it could even be Fe2O3, right? The hematite ore, or Fe3O4. It's a compound of iron and oxygen. And this is magnetite, whereas this was hematite. So all of these are minerals. All of these are minerals. They are falling in the definition of minerals. So, the minerals, they can be elements, or the minerals, they can even be compounds which occur naturally at the rate of the earth's crust. Don't write at the rate, all that means in the earth's crust. But now, what is an ore? Ore is any mineral which should be, which should follow any of these two conditions, not any, both of these two conditions. Number one, ore is that mineral in which the percentage of that respective metal. Now, usually in metallurgy, we will be concerned with the metal. Non-metals, we are not concerned with practically, so only metals we'll be talking about. Okay. So, any mineral is, ore is that mineral in which, number one, there is an increased percentage of that respective metal, and number two, the extraction of the metal from that ore is easy and profitable. So, how will you define an ore for me? Ore is any mineral in which the metal which occurs in that mineral is in a higher concentration, and extraction of the metal from that mineral is easy and profitable. So, that becomes an ore. For example, you have hematite. Hematite, that is Fe2O3. So, hematite is present in two places. For example, one in MP, Madhya Pradesh, and one in UP. Okay. So, in MP, the hematite, the percentage of iron, the percentage of iron in Fe2O3, for example, is 70%. In UP, the percentage is only 35%. Okay, the percentage of metal, iron in Fe2O3, here the yield will be 70%, here it will be 35%. And number two, in MP, it is present relatively superficial at the earth's crust, not very deep. That means mining will be easy and the workload and the man force required will be lesser. Whereas in UP, it is present very deep. Say, for example, means very deep, for example, whatever feet, 3,000, 4,000 feet under the ground level or sea level. So, it's difficult to mine and extract that. So, Fe2O3, that is hematite, it is present, it is occurring both in MP and UP. That means both MP as well as UP, they have this mineral. But if I ask you which one is an ore, it's MP which is having the ore of hematite. Because from here, number one, the concentration is more, and number two, the mining process or extraction will be easy and profitable. Now, extraction of metals, there are three categories of metals based on the RS, that is reactivity series. Those metals which are, number one, in the top of the reactivity series, number two, in the middle, and obviously, number three, in the bottom. So, in the bottom, the metals that you have, you know this. Reactivity series, everyone knows. There were many people who came in front of the class and recited it for us, right? So, bottom, these are the metals which are obviously the least reactive. Number two, because they are so less reactive, they are usually present in a free state. Means usually they do not combine with anyone. They are present just like that. For example, it is copper, so it is present only in the form of copper, or gold, it is formed only in the form of gold. Usually they are not in a combined state, but sometimes even if they have to combine, then they may be in the form of OSOs. Remember OS, okay? OSOs. That means, for example, mercury, it can be in the form of HgO and HgS in the form of their oxide, and in the form of their sulfide, they can be present. Usually they are present in the free state, means only copper or only Au gold or only Ag alone. But if they have to be in a combined state, then they usually combine with O, that is oxide, or S, that is sulfide. So HgO or HgS can be a possibility. You have to know the names of all of them. These are five. All of these are those which you remember in the reactivity series, the metals which are present just below hydrogen. Just below hydrogen, it was Cm, Cm, then silver, gold, and platinum. So C was copper, M is mercury, silver, gold, and platinum. Mind you, silver is Ag and gold is Au, and Pt is platinum. So all of these five are under this category, that is metals in the bottom of the RS. Copper and mercury are the ones that we are interested more so in this chapter, and NCRT has a mention of them, so we'll discuss them in greater details. Right, so this is bottom. Now coming to those which are at the top. Those which are at the top, they will be obviously the most reactive. They will be usually found in a combined state. They will never be alone. Like, you cannot expect sodium to be present alone as sodium. It will be maybe in the form of sodium oxide, sodium chloride, sodium carbonate, sodium sulfate, sodium phosphate. Different combinations, different salts, different compounds of sodium will be there. Examples of these metals which are in the top of the reactivity series. Everyone knows reactivity series. It starts with potassium, then sodium. Then first milk, doodh, pehle peena hai. That for calcium, then Maggi is inferior to that, magnesium. And then fifth was aluminium. So these are again five metals which are in the category of top of the RS. Right? And those which are in the middle, they are of moderate reactivity. And these are present in combined form in the form of cos. Remember, the bottom ones were in the form of os. The bottom ones were in the form of os. The middle ones are in the form of cos, means carbonates, oxides, and sulfides. Carbonate, what is carbonate? CO3 minus 2. Carbonate oxide, O minus 2, and sulfide is S minus 2. Examples of these are the zip metals. Again, these are three. You have to remember these by heart. Zip, that means zinc, iron, and Pb is lead. Pb is lead. Okay, zip metals, these are in the middle of the reactivity series. Now you are seeing all of them are occurring in the form of oxide. The most reactive, they can also be in the form of oxide, for example, sodium oxide. Okay, then the middle reactive, zinc, iron, and lead, you can always have zinc oxide. And even the bottom ones, they were also occurring in the form of os, that is oxides and sulfides, for example, mercury oxide. So why all of them are occurring in the form of oxides? Because there are two logics. Come on, tell me. Number one, oxygen, it is very abundant. So oxygen itself is very abundant. It is present everywhere. It is present everywhere. It's an abundant thing. Okay. Abundant and universal in occurrence. And number two, oxygen itself is very reactive. So it readily forms bonds with other metals, no matter whether they are top, middle, or low in the reactivity series. Now, what will be the steps? What will be the steps of this metallurgy? First, you need to know metallurgy, the definition. Then we'll talk about enrichment, a process called enrichment. Then a process called concentration. Then there are two more processes we'll discuss. Number four would be calcination. Number five, roasting. And finally, will come R reduction and P purification. So what is the order of steps? Number 1, number 2, number 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. So firstly, for any ore, you have to do their enrichment. Then you do their concentration. Then depending on the top of the reactivity series, you go for electrolysis. In the middle or bottom, you go for either calcination or roasting. Once you have that, you have to do reduction or sometimes even displacement reactions. And then you finally have to do the refining or the purification. So these are the various processes that you need to keep in mind. Okay, so let's start them in a very systematic way. First, tell me, what is metallurgy? Metallurgy, it is the process of EOM, extraction of metals from where? Obviously from their ores easily and profitably. Okay, so that is metallurgy. What is enrichment of an ore? Enrichment, for that first you need to know that what is this thing called gang. So you need to know that what is gang actually. Gang, these are the different types of impurities which are present and they contaminate your ore. They contaminate your ore. These are various impurities which can be rocks or sand particles. Okay, so these are various rocks, sand particles, etc. All these impurities which are present along with the ore. So the enrichment is the process by which we remove these gang from our ore. We have to remove these impurities called gang from our ore. And how we do that? So based upon what principle? Based upon the difference. Based upon the difference in the physical and chemical properties. Based upon the difference in the physical and chemical properties of the ore versus from that of the gang. They have different physical and chemical properties. For example, gravity depends on density. For example, your ore particles, they are heavy, whereas your gang particles which are present along with them, green color gang particles, they are lighter. So what you do when you throw water uphill, theek hai, niche se upar ek gush ke saath, bahut high energy ke saath, hum water ko डालेंगे तो इसमें क्या होगा कि जो ग्रीन कलर की जो गैंग पार्टिकल्स हैं बिकॉज दे आर लाइटर दे हैव लो डेंसिटी दे विल रेडिली अंडर द इफेक्ट ऑफ ग्रेविटी सेपरेट फ्रॉम द ओर एंड कम डाउन एंड सेपरेट एंड सारी इम्प्योरिटीज गैंग पार्टिकल्स नीचे सेपरेट हो जाएंगे बिकॉज ऑफ द लोअर डेंसिटी ग्रेविटेशन की वजह से दे विल बी ईजिली पुल्ड बाई ग्रेविटी वेयर एज जो मेटल होगा ओर होगा वो ऊपर के ऊपर फॉर्म में अपना रहेगा तो इस तरह से नीचे गैंग अलग हो गया और ऊपर हमारा मेटल या ओर अलग हो गया ठीक है सो दिस इज़ कॉल्ड इनरिचमेंट ओके सो दिस इज़ कॉल्ड इनरिचमेंट दैट इज़ द डिफरेंस रिमूवल ऑफ द वेरियस गैंग पार्टिकल्स और इम्प्योरिटीज़ फ्रॉम द मेटल और फ्रॉम द ओर एंड द प्रिंसिपल फॉर एनरिचमेंट इज़ डिफरेंस इन द फिजिकल या फिजिकल प्रॉपर्टी अलग थी ना उनकी डेंसिटी उसका मास अलग था कभी कभी केमिकल प्रॉपर्टीज़ भी हम यूज़ कर सकते हैं For example, the solubility in a particular solvent. For example, gang एक particular solvent में dissolve हो जाएगा लेकिन जो metal के particles हैं वो dissolve नहीं होंगे they will settle down और हम उसको वहाँ से ले लेंगे So difference in the physical and chemical properties of ore and gang and that is how you can do enrichment. So I'm ending this part 1 over here. In part 2, we will start with this process of concentration. Thanks a lot for watching.